Hey guys, welcome back to another box break. This time I'm opening something a little bit different. This is the Marvel 80th Anniversary Stickers and Card Set from Panini. This is mostly European exclusive. You can get the stickers in the United States, but not the trading cards, because Panini has no rights to distribute trading cards with Marvel characters in the United States. That right lies solely with Upper Deck. And these are packed a little bit different compared to regular trading cards. You have these thin paper packs. There's four stickers and one trading card in each pack. And also I wanted to talk a little bit about why I have not been uploading in recent weeks. I'm still waiting for my next flare boxes, which was originally what I had planned to open next, but USPS messed up my order and it's stuck in Canada for some reason, which is pretty annoying. So here are the first stickers. So we have the Amazing Spider-Man giant sized annual with the marriage of Spider-Man and Peter Parker, some connecting stickers, some really old stuff, a Captain America cutout sticker as it seems, and here we have one of the trading cards, and it's Warlock, Adam Warlock, nice image. So the base set for the stickers has 192 stickers in it. And there's 50 trading cards. This box contains 36 packs, so I can neither complete the stickers nor the trading cards. Here we have the first issue of the X-Men, a nice Black Panther sticker, a nice Blade sticker, and a foil sticker of Miles Morales Spider-Man, and a trading card with Alex Ross art with Spider-Man on it. And these are pretty cheap. A pack goes for €1, and I bought them for like 80 cents per pack, I think. There's another cutout sticker, a combining sticker with Doctor Strange, Wolverine and Kitty Pride, X-Men 141, I think that is. Here we have another foil Spider-Man sticker and a nice Alex Ross trading card with Vision. I'll do a quick recap, but it's not gonna be too long. I just wanted to see how many duplicates I get out of one box, if I even get some. I already ordered the album for these stickers, so I will show that off in the next video, and I have another box laying around, cutout Thor sticker, Phoenix sticker, Fin Fang Foom, and a nice Falcon trading card. These are a little bit annoying to open, and I don't want to damage the stickers or the cards. Here's a Defenders foil sticker, Captain America and the Human Torch, another Captain America cutout sticker, and Peter Parker on with Parker Industries, and nice Bill Sienkiewicz Nick Fury trading card from the Nick Fury Max Limited series, which was written by Garth Ennis. Awesome series, very funny. Really love that series. Here we have some old school Marvel comics, don't know the character, a nice Wolverine foil sticker, and here we have already the first duplicate, so there's definitely gonna be duplicates on the stickers. First appearance of the Avengers, Miss Marvel and Captain Marvel sticker, oh, and another nice Bill Sienkiewicz Elektra trading card, that's awesome. hopefully I can complete the set, both sets, the trading card and the stickers, with two boxes, but we'll see. They're not as expensive as trading cards, so if I don't complete them, I will buy more of these boxes. Here we have the X-Men Adventures into Terror foil sticker and North Star's Wedding sticker. Oh, and already a duplicate on the trading cards. That's a little bit annoying. Adam Warlock again. And I really damaged the cards or the stickers, whichever. Another cutout sticker, don't know which character it is. A nice Alex Ross artwork sticker with Captain Marvel in the center. Old school Namor foil sticker and another cutout sticker. And a nice Alex Ross Green Goblin. You have to be very careful. It's easy to tear into the stickers or the cards when you open these packages. They're really annoying. Black Panther and Iron Man. Another Captain America sticker. Black Spider-Man. And Ironheart, I think, is the character. Foil sticker. Another nice Alex Ross Black Panther trading card. And I will go into more depth on the set on the next video or videos I will do with them. I will also show off the album then. I've got them in the mail already, but they're not arrived. They have not arrived now. Another cutout sticker. Sticker from Wolverine's first appearance on Hulk. Life with Millie, another classic Marvel comic book. And the Young Avengers sticker. And another Alex Ross, a nice Iron Fist trading card. Very cool. Here's the first appearance of Captain America, Captain America Comics number 1, also a nice foil sticker. Another Captain America connecting sticker. And here we have the, what was it called? Can't remember right now. Here's Peter Parker getting bitten by the radiated spider. Oh, and again the Bill Sienkiewicz Nick Fury. So already several duplicates, which is a little bit annoying, but like I said, they are rather cheap and I will definitely go in for more of them. Here we have some New Mutants cover art by Bill Sienkiewicz, Thor and Beta Ray Bill by Walt Simonson, nice foil sticker, another Black Panther cover and a House of X cover sticker. And awesome Doctor Strange trading card by Alex Ross, or with art by Alex Ross. And like I said, you can find the stickers in the United States, but not the trading cards. Here's Tales to Astonish with Ant-Man and the Wasp. Avengers relaunch number 1, I think. The Zombie foil sticker, Daredevil, and again the Falcon trading card, which I already took. So I probably have to buy a few more boxes of these to complete the set. Oh, and a Jim Lee Punisher, that's nice. Captain America, or Bucky Cap, from the Brubaker run. A random cutout sticker with a destroyed car. Earth X cover by Alex Ross and Nova from its last ongoing series trading card. another Avengers, classic Avengers cover, number 91. Cutout sticker. Classic Fantastic Four, I think that's the issue with the first appearance of the Black Panther. And the X-Force number 1 cover by Rob Liefeld. And again the Black Panther trading card. I hate these packages. Another classic pre-Marvel Universe comic cover. Venus, also a nice foil sticker. Howard the Duck sticker. X-Men cover. And Ultimate X-Men Wolverine cover. Also a nice foil sticker. Oh, and an awesome Punisher trading card. Don't know who the artist is, but this is really nice. Hopefully I can get at least a few duplicates of these, of this one. That would be awesome. Or I will probably. And Rawhide Kid, another classic Marvel comic. The Falcon as Captain America, foil sticker. Werewolf by Night versus, I think that's Frankenstein's monster. Spider-Man from the famous 9/11 issue. An image. And another Alex Ross Green Goblin trading card. Okay. Don't want to damage the cards or the stickers. And a classic Doctor Doom. I think that's Jack Kirby, if I'm not mistaken. Another classic Marvel Comics cover, All Winners, issue number 13. Thanos, Captain Marvel and Death sticker, another Captain America sticker, and a nice Shang-Chi trading card. Sadly, there are no artists credited on the card or the stickers. They're rather boring from the back, as you can see. They're just numbered. So this is what the stickers look like, and this is what the trading cards look like from the back. Another Fantastic Four number 1 sticker. Doctor Strange from one of the more recent Doctor Strange ongoing series. Menace, also a pre-Marvel Universe comic book. And a cutout sticker of Colossus. Oh, and the third Falcon trading card. Wow. So you probably have to buy more than two boxes to open these, but they're not very expensive, so we'll see. Here we have, I think that's the first Invaders iteration, if I'm not mistaken, with Captain America, Falcon, the first Human Torch, Bucky and Toro. Here we have the new X-Men by Grant Morrison, and I think the artist was called Frank Quitely. Another classic Marvel cover. And some Spider-Man interior art. And a nice Guardians of the Galaxy trading card. I think that's also Alex Ross, if I'm not mistaken. And they look really nice, but obviously the stickers are very flimsy and the trading cards are okay. So here we have Captain America cutout sticker. The Hulk and Bruce Banner. A panel from one of the early Avengers comic books, and a nice Thor sticker, and the Alex Ross Doctor Strange again trading card. The Tomb of Dracula number 1 classic Marvel cover sticker, another cutout sticker with a character I don't recognize. Here we have a nice Nick Fury foil sticker with art by Jim Steranko. Edge of Spider-Verse Gwen Stacy cover, I think. And another Invaders cover with Namor, the Human Torch, Captain America as a trading card. and another classic sticker, Incredible Hulk 397, a nice foil sticker again, a Daredevil cutout sticker, and another cover sticker which I don't recognize which book it's from, and another Green Goblin trading card. So lots of duplicates in one box, which is a little bit annoying since you definitely can't complete either one of them, either the stickers or the trading cards with this box. Amazing Fantasy number 15 sticker, first appearance of Spider-Man, Infinity Gauntlet 1, a nice classic Venom cutout sticker, Ultimates sticker, and a Giant Man trading card. Here we have classic Daredevil cover, 181, the Death of Elektra issue. I think that's Runaways, a Runaways cover, a Tales to Astonish cover sticker, and another cutout sticker. And I already pulled the second Punisher trading card, but this one looks really cool. Very happy with that one. The Grey Hulk Jack Kirby sticker and Avengers connecting sticker, Civil War Captain America vs. Iron Man sticker, and another Miles Morales connecting foil sticker, and a nice trading card with X-Men artwork by Alex Ross again. Another Captain America cutout sticker, some random connecting sticker. I think that's the first appearance of Ghost Rider as a sticker. And the Miller Mazzucchelli Born Again trade paperback cover from Daredevil as a sticker. And again the Doctor Strange trading card. Weird Tales, another classic Marvel cover, another cutout sticker with some random character, Marvel Spotlight The Son of Satan sticker, Spider-Man 1 The McFarlane series sticker, and an awesome Thanos trading card. The trading cards look really nice, they're a bit thin compared to regular Upper Deck trading cards, but the printing on them is very nice. Foil Spider-Man sticker, the bottom of the Fin Fang Foom connecting stickers, another Captain America cutout sticker, and another Fantastic Four Jack Kirby sticker, and again the Guardians of the Galaxy trading card. Black Knight cover sticker, Magneto foil sticker from one of the Magneto miniseries, another connecting sticker which I don't recognize, another connecting sticker with the Fantastic Four, and an insane looking Venom trading card. Wow, that's awesome art. They really chose really good art for the trading cards, that's very nice. And again, Black Spider-Man, House of M cover sticker, a connecting Avengers foil sticker, and another part of the first appearance of Wolverine, and again the Punisher, already the third Punisher. Here we have Giant Man and Iron Man sticker, Spider-Man 2099, also one of the more recent series, the left side of the Avengers foil connecting stickers, an Iron Man sticker and a sticker with different appearances or versions of Carol Danvers, Miss Marvel, Captain Marvel, Binary and Warbird. And here we have the Man-Thing. Not its first appearance, but its first issue from its first ongoing series. Another cutout sticker. Another classic Captain America sticker. A nice Iron Man foil sticker. And again, the Giant Man trading card. Another Captain America cutout. Jane Foster as Thor, or the female Thor sticker. Another classic Western comic cover. And another connecting sticker. And a nice Spider-Woman by Alex Ross trading card. So we're down to the last two packs, and then I'm gonna do a quick recap and see how many duplicates I found. Here we have another zombie sticker, foil sticker, Age of Apocalypse cover sticker, another Adam Warlock sticker with interior art, and here we have the bottom sticker of the Bucky cap and another Guardians of the Galaxy trading card. So I will probably need several boxes of these to complete the sets, but we'll see. The Legion of Monsters from Marvel Premiere, Miles Morales foil sticker, Luke Cage, or Power Man as he was called back then, sticker, and Cyclops vs. Wolverine sticker, and a nice Magneto trading card. So here's what I got out of the box. Out of the 36 cards I pulled from the box, 14 were duplicates, which is a little bit annoying. I wasn't expecting that many duplicates. And out of the 144 stickers I pulled, I only pulled 7 duplicates. So that's a pretty good pull, I think. And the cards are really awesome. I really like their finish and that they don't have any bordering or lettering on them. They have a really nice matte finish with some glossy highlights on them. And I will go more in depth when I open the next box and I get the sticker album. And I'm not exactly sure on whether I will put the stickers in the album, but we'll see. And that's it for this time. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and maybe till next time. Bye bye.